Hello everyone, myself Dr. Ms. Tejasvi Shrirang Ghadge, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Humanities and Science, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. I welcome all of you in the session of physics. Today we will see the basic concept of polarization. At the end of session, students will able to understand the difference between polarized and unpolarized light, plane of vibration and plane of polarization, isotropic and anisotropic medium, and calcite crystal. These are the content of the session. Let us see what is polarization. The transverse nature of light proves the polarization property. Light coming from common light source is unpolarized light. It can be transformed into different types of polarization by using different optical devices. The state of polarization cannot be recognized by our eyes. The knowledge of polarization is essential for understanding the propagation of electromagnetic waves propagating through waveguides and optical fibers. Polarization is an important physical property of electromagnetic waves which is connected with the traveling character with respect to the direction of propagation of electric and magnetic field vector. Let us see what is unpolarized light. Unpolarized light is a light which oscillates in more than one plane with equal probability at right angles to the direction of propagation. Think for a while. Can you tell any one example of unpolarized light? The phenomenon in which light is restricted to vibrate in only one plane is called polarized light. The polarized light is not produced naturally. It is obtained by converting natural light into polarized light by using optical element. Polarized light consists of waves with the planes of vibration in a single plane normal to the ray of direction. It may be regarded as the resultant of two mutually perpendicular coherent waves having a zero phase difference. The polarization of light describes the shape and locus of waves in which the plane perpendicular to the direction of propagation at a given instant of time and space. Depending upon the locus of wave, light may exhibit three different states of polarization: plane or linear polarization, elliptical polarization, and circular polarization. An unaided human eye cannot identify the state of polarization of a light. However, some insects and animals possess polarization sensitive vision. In plane polarized wave have an oscillations which are strictly confined to a single plane perpendicular to the direction of wave propagation. The plane polarized wave is also called as linearly polarized wave. In circularly polarized light, there is no preference to specific direction of oscillation. A circularly polarized light is the resultant of two coherent linearly polarized waves of equal amplitude oscillating in mutually perpendicular planes and are out of phase by 90 degrees. An elliptically polarized light wave may be regarded as a resultant wave produced due to superposition of two coherent linearly polarized waves having different amplitudes oscillating in mutually perpendicular planes and are out of phase. Diagram shows the unpolarized light linearly, circularly, and elliptically polarized light. The plane in which vibration occurs is known as plane of vibration, and the plane contains the direction of vibration and the direction of propagation. The plane normal to the vibrational light is plane of polarization, and it contains only direction of propagation of light but not the vibrations. When ordinary light is passed through a tourmaline crystal, the light is polarized and the vibrations are confined only in one direction, that is perpendicular to the direction of propagation of light. It describes the plane of vibration and plane of polarization. Now, let us see in detail what is isotropic and anisotropic medium. Isotropic medium is a homogeneous medium. The atoms in the crystal are arranged in a regular periodic manner. Refractive index is same in all the direction. The velocity of light of waves is same in all the direction. When the light is incident on an isotropic medium, it propagates as a single refracted wave. Glass, water, air, these are the examples. Anisotropic medium. It is an heterogeneous medium. The arrangement of atoms differs in different directions and planes. Hence, the physical properties varies with direction. Refractive index is different along different direction. The force of interaction between electron cloud and the lattice is different in different directions. Hence, the natural frequency of electron cloud is dependent on the direction it is vibrating. It results in different velocities in different directions. When light is incident on an isotropic medium, it propagates as a double refracted ray. Calcite, ice, tourmaline, these are the examples. The figure shows the two materials, isotropic and anisotropic. When the light is in isotropic medium, it propagates as a single wave, and when it enters in an anisotropic medium, it propagates as two waves. Anisotropic crystals are again classified as a uniaxial and biaxial. In uniaxial crystal, one of the refracted ray is ordinary and second is extraordinary. Calcite, quartz, tourmaline, these are the examples. While in biaxial crystal, both the refracted rays are extraordinary. Mica, topaz, these are the examples. Now, let us see in detail the structure of calcite crystal. Calcite is a common naturally occurring substance. A large calcite crystal is colorless and transparent. It is also called as Iceland bar. Naturally occurring calcite crystal has a rhombohedral structure. Calcite is crystallized calcium carbonate, CaCO3. It is uniaxial crystal. It is bounded by 6 parallelograms. at the opposite corners, the three angles of 102 degree, and at the other corner, one angle of 102 degree and two angles of 78 degree. What is blunt corner? The corners where the three obtuse angles meet are known as blunt corners. While optic axis is a line bisecting any of the blunt corner, any line parallel to this line is an optic axis. Hence, optic axis is a direction and not a specific line in the crystal. Let us see what is principal section. A plane containing optic axis and a plane perpendicular to the pair of opposite faces of a crystal is called as principal section for that pair of face. A calcite crystal has six faces and three principal sections. A principal section always cuts the surface of calcite crystal in parallelograms having an angle 78 degree and 102 degree. This is the detailed structure and information regarding calcite crystal as uniaxial crystal. These are the references related to the session. Thank you.